Hey everybody, how you doing? Check it out, I have a little bit of a problem. The Great White Buffalo will not start because the battery is deed.
I like peanut butter, I like peanut butter, peanut butter, I like peanut.
Whoa. This port stays on all the time. It can kill the battery. Good news is I have like five, actually now six ways to charge my battery. And I guess I'm gonna have to try my newest. And I primarily got this to kind of keep in her truck. Anyway, that's a different story, but since the Great White Buffalo is dead, I'm gonna try this. So, let's see what this sort of thing comes with right here. Very, very nice. It's really windy today. So here's what we got. Nice little hard shell. It's like soft and hard all together. A little carrying case there, sweet looking blue. Nice little zipper action going on. Let me see if I can do this with just one man hand. All right, well, through the magic of editing, I've got it unzipped, and here's what it comes with. There's the good old instruction manual right there, which is good to know. Open this little flap right here to protect one side from the other, and you have your little charger right there. Nice little finger hole. It's thick foam in here. Very, very nice. Got a little plastic baggie to protect it. Put that thing out of there. I'm gonna put this plastic bag in my back pocket so it doesn't dry. Ooh, very nice. Feels all ruggedized, soft, little rubber action going on. Got some ports here. Look at that. Very nice. There's an on-off switch. There is an input. There's two USB ports. It look like 2.1 amps. There's a power with a little light bulb next to it. It looks like you can change your voltage. And there is a what is that? Another little output there. Huh. Let's see what happens if we try to... Nothing. Well, there's the old engine start where you connect the jumper cables. Ah, you have to turn it on first. Alright, so we're on. Hold the button down. Flashlight. Blinking flashlight. Super duper blinking flashlight. And hold it down and it should go off. Yay! Okay, so, well, that's pretty, look at this nice little display right here. Made by Victsing, I think, called Jumpstarter. Backlit blue LED, says 100% charge. Very, very nice. Set for output. This thing will charge all sorts of things. Part of the reason why I got it. So that requires the accessories. All right. So there's what you'd use to jumpstart a car, which we'll do in just a minute. Comes with these awesome little plugins to charge a laptop or a tablet or something that requires these sort of plugs right here. Comes with the little cable to connect this stuff to whatever you're going to plug it into. Comes with a cigarette lighter adapter to actually charge the charger with your car. So once your car gets charged or jumped off and running down the road, you can plug this thing in and charge it up. Very nice. There is a wall plug to keep it charged up. You should charge this thing every 3 months or so if you don't use it. Or you can just look at the little display and figure out how low it is and keep it charged. Comes with a flat ribble USB cable. Little mini USB. Very, very nice. So you can plug in stuff like cell phones and tablets and such to the 2.1 amp USB ports, of which it has two. But primarily what I'm concerned with is actually using this thing to try to jumpstart the van. This thing has a maximum of 500 amps to crank and normally runs at 250. It should jumpstart a little nice little four-cylinder car pretty easy, maybe even a six-cylinder, but I got a big old V8. I have a 5.9 liter V8. Yeah. So I don't know if it's going to work. So if this doesn't work, I have this. And if that doesn't work, then I'll have to use the old trickle charger that I have in my garage. So hopefully we'll see. So this is a good test for this thing, which I just got. So I think what I need to do at this point is plug it up and look. Let's see. Well, that's pretty nice. The little plugs here are different shapes so that you can do it only the one way, which is the right way. So it's keyed. So, if you're ever going to use one of these things, before you connect it to your car, make sure it's off. So now I'm in the off position. I can connect the old cables there and we'll plug this into the van and see what's up. Bam! done. So here's the Great White Buffalo. This is the battery. This is the negative side. The battery's right here. That's the positive side. Here's the old Victsing 13,600 milliamp hour battery. Jumpstarter combination. These cables are pretty short. That's not too helpful. One of the reasons why I do like using these little jump starters is you don't have to fiddle around with jumper cables and stuff. You can just connect it and then turn it on and fire it right up, hopefully. Can't see what I'm doing. So when you're gonna connect this sort of thing, even though it's actually off and you wanna make sure it's off, I'm gonna do the negative side first. Oh, and here's a little tip for you. See this little groove in here? If you get the teeth, like right in here, right in there, if you get the teeth in the groove, it'll give you a better connection. That's kinda why that's there. Alright, so we got that on. Now I'll connect the positive. And remember, this is off, so it shouldn't spark or anything. If it will spark, or it does spark, it'll scare the shit out of me. Good little connection there. Feels nice. Here's the old jump box. Alright. So what I have to do now is turn it on, and then I should be able to crank the car over. I have to get my keys, because I wasn't quite prepared for that part. Bam! Got them. Yeah. If you want to know how to make one of these cool little, key things here, it's a previous video, you can see it in my list. All right, so I've got it, everything is connected. I'm doing one last check before I start the car. All right, everything's out of the way. Turn this thing on and I should be able to go and hopefully crank it up. Now this thing, I believe, does not have enough power to actually start this big V8, but we'll see. This will be a test. Okay, it's on. And got the little screen, 100% fully charged. All right, let's see what happens. Hey, look at that. 7 to 11. May not be enough. I better be quick about it. What? What? Hell yeah! I am very surprised. Okay. Alright, so I need to go ahead and remove it. You turn it off? Right? Yes, it's off. I had to look. And then you basically disconnect it. All right, so it's been disconnected.
After you jump start a vehicle, you're supposed to let this thing cool down for like 10 minutes before you try to charge it back up to 100%. It's not hot, it's just, that's just what it says. So this is by Victsing 13,600 milliamp hours, which is 13.6 hours of charge. USB ports, imports you can actually, or inputs you can actually plug into the little cable and use your vehicle to charge it back up. You can plug it into the wall. It's got the wall plug right here. Charge up a sweet laptop or a tablet if you can use that connection. Or if you got like an iPad or something, you can use your USB cable. This is for Android, so you can charge your cell phone. You can charge all sorts of stuff. Nice little instruction manual that comes with it. Oh, here's one thing I need to talk about real quick. If you decide to buy one of these things, and you're gonna charge a laptop, you press this button right here and you can actually select the correct voltage between 12, 16, and 19 volts. So make sure you know which one you have before you do it. Battery status, voltage, easy connection. The only thing I'm not particularly fond of, these are almost too short. Almost. If you had like a really big battery, these cables would be too short. Overall, very impressed. So. That's pretty cool. Just so you know, I've had that port with stuff plugged in, like in my van, sitting there for over 2 weeks. Because that's the last time we drove the van. I meant to go back out and undo it. I didn't do it. You know, it happens, man. Kind of lazy sometimes. I mean, what are you going to do? But that's over 2 weeks. So, but yeah, very impressed with this charger, man. It actually worked. And this was not like a test that I was going to do, because I didn't even think that the van was dead, and it was, and it worked. So that's a benefit to you. So hey, I'll put a link in the description if you're interested in something like that. But yeah, these little jump starters, man, look how small that thing is. I mean, it's like, look, yeah, it's the size of your dad's old cell phone. Questions, comments, anything like that, let me know. I do appreciate them. If you subscribe to my channel, I very much appreciate that too. A little thumbs up if you like this video. If you don't like it, thumbs down, that's okay. But anyway, thank you very much for watching. Take it easy. See you later. Bye-bye.
Hey, everybody. How you doing? If you like the video, hit subscribe. I appreciate it. See you later.
I like peanut butter. I like peanut butter. I like peanut butter. Peanut butter.